Hello students, so in previous class we just discussed about Pythagoras property and we know what is Pythagoras property. So tell me first, what is Pythagoras property? Yes, we can discuss this. You can see here, this is the base and this is the perpendicular and this is hypotenuse. P square plus b square equal to a square means this side square plus this side square equal to this side square. Then this is the Pythagoras property and it is only applicable for right angle triangle. We can write also ab square plus bc square equal to s square. Understood everyone? So this is Pythagoras property. By this rule we can solve the exercise 6.5 and two questions we already solved in classroom. So again we discuss this because some student will absent in the class. So read the question. PQR is a triangle, right angle at P. If PQ equal to 10 cm and PR equal to 24 cm, find QR. When you read the question, see and read the question carefully. PQR is a triangle, but right angle at P means in P angle it is right angle like this. If you draw this figure, then in P angle right angle, that is PQR, then what is given? PQ equal to 10 cm and PR equal to 24 cm. PQ equal to 10 cm and PR equal to 24 cm. Then find PR. Then find QR, means this side you have to find. So this is 90 degree. This is 90 degree. So what is the formula? This side square plus this side square equal to this side. So write PR square plus PQ square equal to QR square. Got it? So PR value is given, PQ value is given. So write PR means 24, 24 square plus PQ means 10 square. Then QR square, write as it is. So here we also discussed how to find squares in previous classes. So 24 square equal to how much? Yes, who can say? 576 plus 10 square 100 equal to QR square. Here the question is find QR, but here we can found QR square equal to 676. How much? 676. But question is find QR. So what can you do here? You find QR equal to root tower of 676. Then we already discussed how to find root tower. Then what is the answer? Yes, who can say? How can you find? If you multiply 26 into 26, then you get 676. 6 is the 26 is the answer. So 26 centimeter, because both are in centimeter. So 26 centimeter is the answer. So this is all about your question number 1. Same thing, question number 2. ABC is a triangle, right angle at C, AB equal to 25 cm and AC equal to 7 cm. Find BC. By yourself you do this. Now move to question number 3. That is, a 15 meter long ladder, a 15 meter long ladder reached a window 12 meter high. This is the ladder, then it reached a window. Here one window is there, just imagine that. Then it is 15 meter height from the ground. On the placing it against the wall at a distance A, find the distance of the foot of the ladder from the wall. Means think this is your house. One ladder is put like this, then this is your wall. Then now question is asking, find the distance of the foot of the ladder from the wall. From here to here, how much distance we have to found? See here. This is, just think about your home. Think about two wall. Both make perpendicular to each other, means this angle is 90 degree. Got it? So now, it is a right angle triangle. So you can apply Pythagoras property. When you apply Pythagoras property? In right angle triangle only. So now this is 90 degree, means this is the hypotenuse, this is the base, and this is the perpendicular. So this value is given, this value is given, you have to find A here. So write the formula first. So what is the formula? This side square plus this side square equal to that side square. So what can I write? A square, because here A is given, here 12 plus 12 square equal to, what is given here? 15. So 15 square, this is the formula. Got it? So what can I do? We have to find here the value of A. Now go to the, now think, when you solve linear equation, how can you solve? Which value is unknown? You keep the number in one side and other numbers you bring to left hand side. So now find first A square plus 12 square equal to 144, 15 square equal to 225. Then A square equal to 225 minus 144. Got it? So what can you do now? Just subtract and write. So A square equal to 81. Then we have to find the value of A. So what is the root over of 81? Yes. First you think here. By multiply which two number you get 81? By multiply which two number? And the number should be equal. By multiply which same number you get 81? 9 into 9 is 81. So root A equal to root over of 81, that is 9 centimeter. So the distance of the foot of the ladder from the wall is 9 centimeter. So this is very easy. Now go to question number 4. Which of the following can be sides of a right triangle? What we can say? When a right angle triangle, then we can apply Pythagoras property, and vice versa we can say when Pythagoras property satisfied, then this triangle should be a right angle triangle. Let me explain again. First thing is, if this is a right angle triangle, then it satisfies Pythagoras property. Got it? And same, if one triangle is satisfied Pythagoras property, then it must be one right angle triangle. Means one triangle is given like this, and here given sides 2.5 centimeter, 6.5 centimeter, 6 centimeter. Then you have to find here, this is right angle triangle or not. How can you do? So you put formula, Pythagoras property formula. If it is satisfied, means LHS equal to RHS, then it is a right angle triangle. So let's see, first question we solve here. So three sides given 2.5 centimeter. Question number 4i, 2.5 centimeter, 6.5 centimeter, and 6 centimeter. Three sides are given. Am I right? So now, what is Pythagoras property? The sum of square of two sides equal to third side. So here 6.5 cm is the greatest side. So most be it is the hypotenuse. Then you have to find 2.5 square plus 6 square. It must be 6.5 square. Means this side is LHS and this side is RHS, means this is left hand side and this is right hand side. Got it? If both are equal, then it must be an right angle triangle. So now find out 2.5. We know the square of 2 square equal to 4, 3 square equal to 9. So here how can we found? We multiply 2 and 2, 3 and 3 like this. 2.5 square means you have to multiply 2.5 into 2.5. I already told you how to multiply decimal numbers. So now forget this is a decimal point. Now simply multiply 5 5 is 25, here carry 2, 5 2 is 10 plus 2 12, 2 5 is 10, carry 1, 2 2 is 4 1 5. Now add 625 you got. So here you can see after point how many number is there, 1. Here also after point 1 number is there. So total 2 number is there after point. So from left side you left 2 number and put point 6.25. Then 2.5 square equal to 6.25, 6 square equal to 36, 6.5 square, like this you can find. 5 5 is 25, 2, 32, here 39. Now same 42.25. Now add this 36 plus 6, 42.25. This side also 42.25. So LHS equal to RHS. So both the side, both in this side 42.25, here also 42.25. So it is satisfies Pythagoras property. So it is satisfy Pythagoras property. So these sides of a, these are the sides of a right angle triangle. Got it? So like this you can solve question number 4. So for today's class we should stop here. In next class we discuss more. So thank you students, and complete all the exercises and watch the video properly. If you don't understand, watch it again. After that we can take your online classes. If you have any doubt, then you can ask me. Thank you students.